With both our kids, we seem to have trouble with the whole where to park, where to walk, and the hospital as we were having the babies. So with Olivia, we parked at the top of a parking garage where there was a walkway, like a covered walkway over to the maternity area. But it was 2 a.m. and the door into the hospital was locked. And so we were standing outside and there was a call box, and George was trying to talk to the person to get them to open the door. And they wouldn't open the door, so he told them that his wife was about to have a baby in the parking lot, hoping that that would make him open the door. But he still wouldn't open the door, so we had to drive to another area of the hospital, park. And as we're walking in, I see my midwife and a nurse running out of the hospital with blankets. And I realized that they're coming for me. We got into the, into the room, and she checked me and she was like, "You're gonna have this baby right now." And I was like, "George, I don't think she really knows what she's talking about." But it turns out it was 2 pushes and there she was. So we actually did almost have the baby in the parking lot. We just didn't know it.
One of my favorite memories of Liv as a little kid, it's really Olivia and Clay, is when I would leave for work in the morning. They would sit on the back of the couch and look out this window that overlooked the driveway. So I'd go out in the car, pull halfway down the driveway and stop, roll down the window and look at them, with my arms up and shoulders shrugged, like, "Which way do I go?" And they would start, "Go that way, go that way," and they'd be pointing down the road, and Clay would be earnestly telling me which direction I had to go to get to work, and Olivia would just be cracking up, just so happy to be a part of this little ritual, and she seemed to know that it was all for fun, and she was having a ton of fun. But man, I'll never forget just looking back in that window and seeing these two little kids so happy.
One of the things that Olivia taught people was that a person's worth is not based on what they accomplish or what they're good at or what they can do. She showed people, and me especially, that our worth is, you know, it's immeasurable and it's intrinsically ours simply because we are. So many people saw her beauty and her grace and her joy and, you know, felt her worth, even though she could do really so little.
The grace with which she faced her challenges. I mean, she had significant challenges and it couldn't have been fun, but she was never, you know, she never felt bad for herself. She never cried or, you know, she was just so graceful and just so great to be around. She didn't have to do anything to please anybody. She just had this aura about her. She was just so peaceful. And I mean, just look at the outpouring we've had. I mean, she touched so many people's lives. You know, it humbles me.